It's Vaygrim. Back again for another episode of Let's Play. The first one was very well received, some very positive comments, and I thank you on that. As you may have noticed, I've been rather busy with my tree farming. I've done some off-camera work between the first episode and the second one, so we can get a better kickstart on things. There is a jungle not too far off that way, and to my west, and that's where I got that massive tree. There is a fir pine forest, I think it's called, a pine forest, off that direction, pretty far. Let me see if I can bring up the map here. Way off up here, you can see this. I have not explored yet. I don't know what that is, but a lot of dead-looking, weird kind of trees. So yeah, this is a magical forest. Very, very cool. Up this direction is a coniferous forest. That's where I got one of those other tall trees from. This is a hot springs. And right here, you'll see this pool. Hot springs water. If you stand in that stuff, it will heal you. And I think even replenish your food meter. But anyway, so I've been rather busy. Now, one thing you might notice is missing is our hole. Where did our hobble go? Well, actually, it's right here. These are, as you can see in the bottom right-hand corner, these are not just normal trapdoors. These are hatches from the Carpenter's Blocks mod. Fantastic mod. Basically, they act as hatches and as ladders. If you'll notice, when I climb up out, yeah, I get that kind of ladder function. I don't even have to jump. And I can get down here and close these. And the top of them looks like grass. Right there, you see? Isn't that fantastic? I love that. All you have to do is make... Well, I'll tell you what. I'll show you how those things work in a little bit. Now, this is the hobble. And as you've noticed, I've expanded quite a bit. I've got more chests. And I've got my wall of... This is what all my wood has been going to. I've got my wall of barrels from the Jabba mod. Excuse me. I still have a bit of a cold going on. These things are fantastic. I absolutely love these things. They're upgradable, and they're upgradable in place, which means I don't have to take the whole contents out to upgrade them. I can just right-click them with something. see, mining, gathering resources. As you can see, I've got redstone, I've got diamond, I've got a little bit of gold. That's been the hardest to find, actually, is the gold. Oh, some yellowite from big reactors, but I don't think we're going to be messing with that for quite a while. I've got some thermal expansion ores. I've got osmium, iron, copper, tin, lead, silver, the works. The only thing I really haven't been doing a lot of is processing that ore, because I want to make sure I have a big ore doubling operation in place before I do anything real big with a lot of my ore. Oh, you know what? It's getting to be nighttime. I'm going to go take a quick rest and cycle it back to day so we can get some work done. Now, the first thing that I actually smelted up iron ingots for was this setup right here. Down here in the bottom, you know what, I'll do it this way. Mod remote IO. This is a lava-powered heater. Recipe coming up. Basically, you make a furnace, some iron bars, that's what I had to make the iron for, and a bucket, of course, and some cobblestone, and it makes this block. What you can do is put this block directly under a furnace, a normal, ordinary, vanilla furnace, and you put a source block of lava on the left and on the right, and what that gives you is a permanently heated furnace. Very, very nice, which means I can go up here. I'll just put that in there. I'm going to grab another block, and you'll see it goes. I invested some time and some iron ingots into making this so I could save coal for early game, so I can use coal for other things later, and we'll get around to that. Nearby in a village, actually, I think you can see it right here. Now, this village is kind of weird. It looks big, but it's actually not that huge, and there were no villagers there. I'm not sure if this is in enough of a radius that they got killed by monsters overnight. I really hope not, but there is this. I went and raided it for the Tinker's Construct tables. So I've got those set up. And behind there, I think you can see, there is a pattern chest with some patterns that I have made. I got these out of the table, out of the village. So that was very, very lucky, very fortuitous. This is very interesting. This is something that I will go into a little bit later. This has to do with the new mod that's out called Crafting Suite, which is what this has to do with. This is my fast grab stone pickaxe table, basically, right there. Very nice. So, I've been a busy little monkey, but there's a lot of progress that I wanted to save until I was actually talking to you folks. Let's see. Oh, various chests that I've looted from dungeons. Oh, this is one thing I'm going to want to grab. I found this in a spawner that I found down in my mines. That spawner, basically, had a chest in it. Only one chest, strangely enough. But it was a skeleton spawner. And I think I have it right there. Now, you're going to ask, how did you pick that up? Well, actually, that's a perfectly good question. One of the things that I've also made some iron for and some other resources was to make myself a strong box. This is from Thermal Expansion. These things retain their inventory, and you can pick them up. They're also upgradable. Several steps. They're very, very nice. I made a force wrench. Now, there's a lot of stuff about dart craft that I think is kind of overpowered or kind of imbalanced, but there's a lot of it that I think is actually super useful, and I just don't want to pass up. The force wrench is extremely useful. One thing I'm going to be using this for long run is collecting spawners. I have a goal of making a super monster factory, basically, long game. I want to make one massive structure that has every spawner imaginable, and I can use that to crank out all my monster drops. I really think that's going to be a great notion. I have a backup crafting table in here, some spare tools. I have a furnace. This little guy right here, luggage from Open Locks. He follows me around, I think. Maybe he does. Usually he does. Anyway, he darts around and gobbles up spare blocks that drop. So he gets a lot of my minings, and then I can pick him up with contents intact and put him back in here and take him with me. And then all of this, I pick up with my trusty crescent hammer and pack it away. Very, very nice. I'm looking to upgrading that strong box and getting more space later on. So, the first thing we're going to want to do today is grab some wood. Now, I have a lot of cherry wood, but if you'll notice, I have 11 stacks, plus a little extra, of jungle wood. I have some birch up there that I gathered, some fir. So what I'm going to do, let's just do it that way. Okay. We're going to get some wood. Let's just close that up behind us. Now, what I want to do is I want to build a house. I think I'm going to run it. Oh, my rubber tree finally grew. Parallel right here to the hovel. And I want to get basically us some housing going so we can have a bit of safety. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think one more. I think. Can I eyeball on this? Tell you what I'm going to have to do. Speak of the devil. I'm going to put you down temporarily. Grab myself an axe. I'm going to have to move you so I can make my house. I am very sorry. Now, the wonders of the builder's wand. As long as I have resources, I Go away. Can make myself a quick and easy. Okay. It even automatically adapts to terrain height changes. There we go. This thing is great for quick buildings. Now, this is not going to be the prettiest house in the world. We will solve that problem at a later date. Right now, the biggest problem I've been trying to conquer is the fact that we have a zombie problem, as well as Hecates. Some people call them Hecates, but I believe it's actually pronounced Hecates. It's a mob that's added by Ars Magica, and they are nasty. Nasty, nasty, nasty. Now, I'm just going to go downstairs here. What was I going to grab? Oh, yes. I'm going to grab a stack of those. We need a door. Somewhere right around here will do. Now, handy dandy shovel. Just clear out some landscape here. And put some flooring in. Okay. One thing I also wanted to discuss is what mods that I've got installed, and I will be going over that more in detail here in a little bit. There's some that I've already been messing with. As you can see over there, that's my punt. That's from Small Boats, and it is a wonderful little thing. I love it. I've been using it to explore the various... Wow, I am out of that wood already. How rude. A stack goes out fast. Okay. Stack. We jump up here and then edge over. Boom. Okay. Now there's something that I've been wanting to build. Let's see. What's the recipe for one of those? Sticks and string. I do have sticks. Hey. And I can have sticks very, very quickly. Okay, now, there is a method to my madness. I'm going to do that real quick. I'm going to put down some temporary torches until we can get some better lighting going on. And over here in the corner, there we go. Okay. Now, why on earth have I dug a hole? That's why. Rope ladder. Okay. Now we have quick and dirty access into our hovel without having to go outside. I can start moving some of these crafting to benches inside. I'm gonna leave that one. And let's put this back. Put that back. Okay. Go back upstairs real quick. And let's put those right there. Actually, okay. Let me just get some more sticks here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make some carpenter's blocks. Now, and I believe there's a way. I don't know if I have two iron ingots to spare or if I'm going to have to smelt them up, but I have one to spare. Take another one. Let me put this away. And we'll see how this is going to go. Now, what did I do? That's strange. Okay. Darkcraft iron is apparently a new addition. Huh. I'll have to look into that. I'm not sure what that's about. Let's get this smelted. Now, I've been thinking about normally what I would do. In my normal personal game, what I would actually do for ore processing is actually get a mechanism setup going. Oh, I need three. Normally, that's what I would do. But I need to explore different options. I know that Mariculture actually has ore processing. It looks very interesting. It involves lava and ice. Now, I have ice. Or lava. I have access to lava. I've got access to tons of lava. But I don't have any ice. And I have not found any polar There we go. And we can I need another one. Because I think that looks neat. You just right-click on the block, and you can make it look like what you want. Isn't that cool? And I have options. Yeah, wire mesh door, glass pane, solid boring door, I like that one. I like being able to see who's trying to take my door off its hinges. Now, interesting point about these doors. If you actually use an iron block on them, or actually, I think it's an iron ingot. If you use iron on them and give them an iron texture, they actually take on the attributes of an iron door, which means they can't be broken and they can only be opened by redstone signal. Very, very interesting stuff. So, I was talking about mariculture. Mariculture has tons of stuff, but they have an industrial smelter, which basically turns your ore into liquid. Sound familiar? And then an industrial freezer, which gets that liquid and doubles it back into ingots. The only hitch is, I don't have any ice. And I haven't even... I see this over here. So I think what I'm going to have to do is go during the day, but I don't have a silk touch pick either. What to do? Yeah. I think I'm going to have to go into thermal expansion first. Let me do some research real quick and see if I can come up with an option. I'll be right back. Okay. I think we are set up now. Basically, what I've got in my inventory, a list of ingredients. What I've decided is I wanted to start with mariculture, but mariculture requires ice in order to turn the liquid metal back into ingots, and I don't have an easy solution to ice right now. I could go thermal expansion and do that as my startup, but I think a lot of people are already familiar with thermal expansion, and I think it's going to get a lot of coverage. It's not real different from what it was before. Now there's just one extra step. You make the power source instead of using buildcraft power. I wanted to use mariculture, but I don't have access to make ice or silk touch to get ice. So that leaves me with the next thing I'm going to try, which is going to be mechanism. Now, I use mechanism constantly. It is my go-to mod for almost everything now. But I know there's a lot of people that still have problems with their early game and mechanism, which is why I've decided to go this way. A lot of people, I think, could benefit from learning exactly what I'm doing. Now, I'm going to have to go with something that's called, let me find it right there, the heat generator. The heat generator is not very expensive. It's easy to make. Requires no special ingredients. We are, unfortunately, going to have to use some ingots before we can get our ore processing up to double our ingots. But there's no way around that. You're going to have to do that anyway. So basically, you sacrifice resources to make more later. It's okay. So the heat generator works two ways. You can either put coal into it or anything burnable, and it'll generate a moderate amount of power. Or you can surround it with lava. Now, lava is very, very good, but lava has, shall we say, safety problems. When you're using lava,
do I have any wood? Yeah, I do have wood.
Let's say that is a source block of lava, right? It is going to want to check two blocks away from itself in all directions and five straight up for anything that's flammable. So it goes two blocks out and five blocks up. It makes a column, basically. And if there's any wood within that space, that wood will continuously catch fire until it finally burns. So that means that the new nice wooden house that we just made upstairs isn't going to work very well for what we need to do. So, there's some copper hiding behind my wall here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make my power and my ore processing down here. The house upstairs, we can move into it later when we have, we can move the ore processing into it later. We have more, let's say wood-friendly power alternatives. Let's go that way. Gonna fill that in. So, actually, I'm gonna need more space. What I'm going to do, what I'm actually doing right here is basically making an up space for a starter generator. And I will put that there. We'll figure it out. Okay, so we'll go back up here. First thing we're going to have to do is going to have to make the... Oh, goodness, where did I put it? The generator itself. Now, I already have some of these materials set up. I believe it looks something like that. There's my heat generator. And what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to place that right there. And then I kill this block. I want it floating because we are going to have to cover it in all sides with lava. Now here's where the interesting part gets, right? I need to make some power cables, universal cables, but that requires steel. Well, you're saying, how do you make steel early game? Here's the thing, right? Most people don't know that you can do... Is it alt signs? Hang on just a sec. Let me do some quick research. Okay. We're back. Quick amount of research. So there used to be a point in time when Buildcraft had the option to put an iron ingot and surround it on four sides with coal. And apparently, in my version at least, in some config file I've got, has been turned off. But that's fine. It's not a hurdle. What we need to do, we've got our power source right here. And what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to empty, don't try this at home, kids, a bucket of lava, piece of glass. Now that lava is going to flow around all sides. I wonder if my backyard's on fire now. And I have a spider on my head. I wonder if I've calculated my height properly. Oh yeah, this is raised one more level. It should be fine. Should be. I guess if we go back upstairs, my house is on fire. We'll know. So this thing is charging up. You'll see right here. Because the lava is surrounding it, it is basically charging up constantly, building up power. Now, this thing is actually pretty good for early game power, and they do really good long term. So don't sneeze at this as some kind of a crappy little starter solution. It's actually pretty nice. What we've got now is basically a thermal generator. I could put coal into it, see, and you hear the noise kick on. It's got a fuel count. But we want as much passive power generation as possible in order to save on our resources. Now, the next hurdle I want is that I want some cables. But it requires steel ingots. The thing is, in order to make what we want, the enrichment chamber, this is what lets us double our ore. It turns every ore into two dust. We need to make some of these things, which means we need a metallurgic infuser. And then you can use this to make steel anyway. So, that problem gets solved. What we do is go over here to the metallurgic infuser and look. I need to go like that. Pull that out directly, and we can literally put this straight in front, and there's our charge, building straight up. Now, there's a couple things you can do with this. We need 1, 2, iron. Sound kicks on. Now, I don't have any upgrades in this, of course. I just made it, but still. There's 2 of these enriched iron that we'll get. Now, in the meantime, I need to make some of these things. 4 of them, to be exact. No, I need 6. Because... wow, I hope that works. Okay, I'm going to take those. Oh, my glass is ready. Hooray. Come over here. Ooh. That's going to require a second pass. I did not realize that. That's new. That's changed. Okay. This is a learning process for both of us. I might have to tune the noise level down on this a little bit in editing. Here's the one thing I think is interesting about Aiden's machines and mechanism. Get a little farther away, gets quieter. A little farther away, gets quieter. Gets quieter. Louder and louder and louder and louder. I have to admit that takes some programming prowess. That's very, very neat. So this one little heat generator is holding up very, very well for us right now. We have now our enriched alloy. That's a component. Now what we have to do is put these back in here. Put some charcoal into it again. I mean some coal into it again. We have 1, 2 steel dust that we can stick into our furnace over here and turn back into ingots. There we go. I would like ingots out of those, please. In the meantime, we can... I wonder if this works. Hey, it does! Awesome! Cross-mod compatibility. Woohoo! Okay. Now we want to turn a lot of these ingredients we've got into... some kind of magical machine. I need 2 of those. Oh, I just remembered. I actually still need that because I need 1, 2, 3, 4. I need steel for the casing. Now, what we can do is we can do steel ingot on either side of a piece of redstone, and we get our universal cable. Whoops. Okay. Man, this thing is loud. Okay, so now what I can do, cable, 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 put you down right there, and it's got power, which means now I can get my... machine, my enriching chamber set up right there. I'm going to back up a little bit. That's kind of loud. Actually, I wonder if that's too loud. Oh. The rain has canceled out the noise. That is very, very weird. Those cooking. And slowly but surely we're getting there. Mm, one more steel ingot. Thank you very much. Now, first thing we need for our enrichment chamber, is four steel ingots around an osmium ingot. That gives us a steel casing. Then we have to do, I think it's this, and that. We have our enrichment chamber. It powers up, and we can still reach back here and check the heat generator, which is still building power. Very nice, very nice. So, now, we have a solution for ore doubling. You know what? I'm going to put this in the tool chest, actually. That goes in there. That goes in there. That goes in there. And what we need to do now is get some gold processed. Well, that's waiting. Oh, I have the most wood of. Let's do okay. So, some of the mods I've got in this pack right now. I've got Ars Magica 2 in here. Got Applied Energistics. Atomic Science. I have Bibliocrat. Let's see. I have Biblio Woods installed. Big reactors. Biomes O'Plenty, of course. And then I have the old standby, Buildcraft. Carpenter's blocks. Carpenter's blocks, I'm going to have to just settle for that. Computercraft. One day I'm going to learn how to program, I swear. Let's start up here with crafting suite, dark craft, dark patch, Enderio. I don't go anywhere without it. How is this coming along? Okay, awesome. We're making progress. I've got Ender storage. I have extra utilities by R.W. Tema. Gravity gun, just because it's super useful. Iron chests, I think that's by CPW, I'm trying to remember them. Java by Professor Mobius. Mariculture, which I'm very interested in taking a look at. Mekanism by Aiden C. Brady. Oh, let's see. Mine Chem, which will be very, very interesting. Mine Factory Reloaded. Morph by Ai Chun. Mistcraft. Natura. I have, the sound keeps cutting in and out in the background. Open blocks. By Mikey Mu and Company. Portal Gun, also by Ai Chun. Project Red, which is going to come in very, very useful long term for some automation solutions. I've got Remote I.O., which is where that furnace heater came from. That's very, very useful. Small boats. Steve Carts, which I actually haven't messed with in a long time. Tinkers. Construct. Then we have Bombcraft 4. We have Atomic Tinker. We have Thermal Expansion 3. We have T-Mech Works, which is a part of T Tinker's Construct. We have Twilight Forest, Wireless Redstone Chicken Bones Edition, and one of the newer things that's actually been bundled in, Redstone Arsenal. Have to be Arsena. Now, there are some other things that I have plugged in. I'll go into those in the next episode. These are the primary content mods right here. These are what you're going to see me. Wow, I'm taking that out for a minute. These are what you're going to see me mess with on a episode-to-episode basis. This is going to be most of the content. Most of what we're going to be messing with. Now, there's some highlights in here of things I really haven't used very much, like MindChem or Mariculture or TMechWorks. I don't even know what's in that. Redstone Arsenal is completely new. Chisel is still a fairly new experience to me. Carpenter's Blocks I've used a little bit before, but I really look getting into it. Atomic Science is new for me. Big Reactors is new for me. But then there's a lot of old standbys, like Railcraft, Enderio, Mekanism, Mistcraft, etc., etc. So yeah, I think it's going to be fun. I'm really going to like getting into this with you guys, and I think we're going to have a good time. So I think this is a really good wrapping up point. I'm going to process some ores, so we'll have a better starting point for next episode, which is when I think I want to start looking at building some docks for my boat. And I can start showing you the ins and outs of small boats and maybe upgrade my punt to something a little bigger. I'm really hoping you found this interesting, and I would love to hear feedback on what you think about the episode and the progress so far. I am looking into bundling my config files up and giving a list to allow you to locate all of the mods and where to download them. I think right now that's going to be the easiest and simplest solution on how to handle that, because distribution is a tricky prospect. So, this is Vaygrim signing off. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.